Hello and welcome to this video talking about an architectural web tool used to generate and analyze bubble diagrams. So this is hosted at wizard.in/bubbles. The link should be in the description, or the most updated version should be. Well, I'll jump straight in and show you what it does, and then we can come back and see the intricacies of the different things. So choose file. I'll choose the file. Basically, this is an area statement which generates this kind of a grid, which onto which we add our proximity diagram, so to speak, or proximity chart. So here we are basically using these as checkboxes to see which ones are connected. So the living and the main bedroom, yes, are connected. So click. Living and bedroom 2, sure, why not? Living and bathroom 1, no. Bathroom 2, sure. And living and kitchen and dining connected, yes. Main bedroom and bathroom and bedroom 2, not necessary. Main bed, bath 1, yes. No, no. Bed 2 and bath 1, no. Bed 2 and bath 2, yes. Bed 2 and kitchen, no. Bath 1 and 2, no. Bath, kitchen, dining, no. Bath, no. So these are the connections that we have for this particular very simple project, which has only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rooms, no, 6 rooms. And so once we selected our the different connections, we just say done, and it creates a bubble diagram for us. We can move this into this, making sure that there are no lines that intersect. That is not allowed in terms of an architectural bubble diagram. So this is a bubble diagram generator. It also does a few other things which we'll go into later. Things like move. But coming back. So what are the different aspects of this that we probably need to pay attention to? First of all, is the CSV file. And the CSV file is basically a spreadsheet download. So let's look at a few of these. These are a few of my students' works in terms of their area statements of a particular project that they're working on. Let's use, say, the pre-BHK thing. I want just the areas and this. Cool. Okay. Let's copy this thing, create a new sheet, paste this here. Okay. It can't be just three. This has to be done thrice. So let's insert. Possibly six. Okay. Yeah, so let's assume that this is our area statement as of now. Let's add a header line above this. Okay. Now all you have to do is download as SV, comma, separated value. Once this is done, it downloads somewhere. Back here. Refresh file. Open. And this is obviously a little more complicated because there are a few more rooms. Forgive the graphics of it, I'll improve it at some point. It definitely helps if we don't use caps lock and stuff. But let's just go through this anyway. So we're looking at foyer, living room, informal living, bedroom 1, 2, 3, dining rooms, kitchens, common spaces, common toilets, sorry, attached toilets, attached toilets, attached toilets, and utility, and a walk-in closet. So I'll come back after all of these things are selected. Okay, I can't work with the caps lock and all of that. So let's just edit that really quick. And the way we do that is use a text editor. So we, let's say, copy this and paste it into, this is Notepad++. But let's just paste it in here. First of all, remove all the space with nothing. So that remove that. Then I don't want any spaces either. I'm gonna remove that. I'm gonna remove the word room from everywhere because they're all rooms. Then what else? That. So we know which one you're talking about. Okay, and now, okay, also, yes. And convert keys to copy this back. Download CSV footage or bubbles, refresh, and little better, still not wonderfully clean. I will work on this soon, but anyway, I will come back after selecting all the different rooms. Give me a second. Alright, so these are the connections that I think make sense with this design. So the foyer connects to the formal living and no other space. The formal living connects to the informal living and the common toilets and obviously the foyer earlier. The informal living connects to obviously the formal living here and bedroom 1, bedroom 2, master bedroom, dining and the common toilet. So this is kind of the main area from which the house splits up, so to speak. So from the formal living you only enter the common the informal living, and from there you go to all the different bedrooms. So bedroom 1 is obviously connected to informal living and to the toilet 1, bedroom 2 to informal living and toilet 2, master bedroom to informal living, toilet 3 and the walk-in closet, the dining room to the informal living, dining and the kitchen and the common toilet. The kitchen to the dining again, and the utility, the common toilet to the dining, informal living and formal living, and nothing else. Toilet 1 to bedroom 1, toilet 2 to bedroom 2, toilet 3 to bedroom 3, and the walk-in closet, and that's it. Okay? So if I just click on done, this is my my bubble diagram for this particular design. This is how you create a bubble diagram. The point I want to make with this is that you don't design a bubble diagram, so to speak. You design your proximity chart. You figure out what are the different spaces next to each other and how they're connected. And just based on that, the rest of your design kind of is generated more than designed. So yeah, so we have the foyer connecting to the outside. You have your formal living, which connects to the informal living, which actually connects to everything else. There is also your common toilet, which actually is connected to three different spaces, and so on. You can kind of analyze your entire structure through, I mean, your entire design through this chart. And yeah, now if you just want to play with it for whatever reason, turn trace back on. It kind of traces the path in which your bubbles have moved safely, and they start moving around. It has a certain level of inertia, and springs, each one of these lines right now starts to act like a spring, so these are pulled together. And anytime you're really close to each other, they kind of push each other apart as well. And so they move about to a certain level. And like I showed you earlier, there is also gravity. Why are these physics things here? I have no idea. So yeah, I hope you use it. If you do, please send me a screenshot of your bubble diagrams and we can talk about them. And possibly further analysis of what is possible with bubble diagrams and what's the point of it and how this might affect design and stuff like that. Cool. Thank you. Hope this helps.